Hello, everybody, and welcome to episode 2 of Attack on Titan season 4. And after the experience that I got from from episode 1, I have no idea what to anticipate with how this season's gonna go. We're 9 years in the future. We just experienced what was the ending of a 4-year war between Marleyans and Eldians. And Marleyans won by a landslide because they had 3 freaking Titans helping them against just a bunch of warriors for the Eldians, which is just so not fair, but, you know, whatever. And now, I guess their now only last thing to do is they're in pursuit of just basically getting back the Founding Titan from Aaron. So, we've kind of got the story scene set in a way. But, you know, with, like, I think there's, like, 25, 26 episodes in this season, plus the 2 specials at the end. Who the hell knows what's going to happen here? I mean, this is just absolutely nuts. So, hopefully we're going to finally see Aaron and the rest of the crew in this episode, at least, because we didn't see them at all in the first one. So, yeah, I want to see what they look like, especially in this new art style. I want to see if I'm going to recognize people or not. So, yeah. So, let's go ahead and do this, guys. Here we go. I'm so excited. Let's do this thing. All right.
ああ、やっと。半島の自治権をめぐる戦争に4年も費やしたあげく、敵艦隊とこちらの主力の巨人2体があわやさし違える失態を演じた。人類の英知はついにマーレの鎧を粉々に砕くに至った。どの国も総報じ、中東連合国を称えている。これがかの大国マーレの勝利だと言えるのか。 マガド、これはどういうことだ？元帥殿、いよいよその時が来たのです。人類が巨人の力を超えるその時だ。我々が巨人の力を過信し、植民地政策を進めるなか、諸外国はそれに抗うべく兵器の開発に力を入れた。その純然たる結果を今突きつけられているのです。それでも我が巨人兵器は 当分の間、陸上戦においては無敵を誇るでしょう。しかし、このまま航空機が発展していけば、爆弾が雨のように降り注ぐ。その時には大地の悪魔たる巨人は、ただ空を見上げ続けるほかなくなるでしょう。羽の生えた巨人はいなかったか。元帥殿。
つまり我々はもう巨人の力に。分かっておる。近い将来我々は戦争の主導権を失う。いや、すでに遅れをとっている。かつては悪魔エルディアを討ち取りし英雄の国マーレが、今や何たることだ。恐れながら元帥殿、進言のご許可賜りたく存じます。
脅威の子ジークよ、言ってみろ。The
シソの巨人奪還を急ぐべきです。マガト隊長のおっしゃる通り、マーレは今後通常兵器の開発に力を注ぐべきです。しかしそれまで諸外国が黙っているでしょうか。今我々に必要なのは軍備再編までの時間、それには一刻も早くマーレがパラディ島を占拠し全ての巨人の力を収めたという新聞の見出しが必要なのです。
お前の任期はあと1年足らずだったな。ええ、コルトが私の獣の能力を全て引き継げるのかとても不安でして。そうだな。残りの1年の命をもって4年前の雪辱を果たしたいというわけか。その通りでございます。あの忌まわしき脅威、グリシャ・イエーガーの行いに終止符を打つのは、
かつての息子である私でなくてはなりません。Interesting.
Okay. So that is very interesting that he says that. Because so that means that he's had his now for 16 years, and then But see, we don't know how long. I'm trying to remember. I think Aaron said that he had 9 years left for his. So technically everybody could all have about a year left. And it's interesting that he says that he doesn't think that Colt can fully obtain those powers. So he wants to get the Founding Titan's powers from Aaron, too. Or back from... But see, the thing is, why would they want to steal the Founding Titan's powers if... Oh, no, I forgot. It can be traded off to other people. Never mind. Interesting. Okay. All right. Well, here we go. Let's see how this thing's going. But first, we have to go diving into the opening. Yes. かつての息子である私でなくてはなりません。 Midnight train. Interesting. Okay.
悪かったな、コルト。お前を出しにしちまって。いや、素晴らしかったです。エルディア人がマーレ軍元帥に意見を通すなんて。ジークさんの獣の能力は歴代とは全く違う。まるで話に聞く始祖の巨人だ。Oh,
so there has been other beast titan. So that means there's definitely been a beast titan before Zeke, an armor titan before Reiner, one for Annie, so on and so forth. Oh, duh, that makes sense, because there's like three different people that had the Founding Titan powers, because it started off with what's his freaking name? With the guy, Historia's dad's brother, and then he passed it down to Frida, and then obviously Grisa, or how do you say his name? I would say Dr. Yeager. Dr. Yeager stole it from obviously Frida, and then he gave it to obviously Aaron now. Okay, so that makes sense. I didn't even think about that. I never even thought about the idea of there being other beast titans and other like armor titans and colossal titans in the past. That's so funny. I'm not sure how that just like really like skipped right over my head. That's so... I didn't even think about that. That's crazy. I didn't even think... What? Wild. Oh my god.
どうして特別なんでしょう?王家の血を引いているわけでもないのに。
Hey, he does. So, his mom is.
結局俺が死ぬまでわからずじまいだろう。
I thought... No?
記憶を継承するお前には知られちまうかもな。俺の秘密を。
He's a big secret.
ですか?
ケツの吹き方が独特なんだ。誰にも言わないでくれ。ダメだ。全て話せ。隊長殿。血芸の数まで申告してもらう。エルディア人にプライバシーは必要か?必要ありません。1年でパラディ島を落とせるらしいな。私には1年しか残されていないという話ですよ。この3年間 パラディ島に向かった調査船は一隻も帰ってきていない。ジーク、お前はこれをどう見る?軍の船が32隻も沈められたのなら、それは巨人一体の仕業とは考えにくい。少なくともエレン・イエーガーを含む巨人が2体以上調査船に立ち塞がったのではないでしょうか。同じ意見だ。島を攻めるには戦艦の支援が必要になるだろう。ええ。そして何より、
敵の脅威は巨人だけじゃない。Oh,
yeah, Mikasa. Oh, Reiner, what's going on, buddy?
楽しい夢でも見てるみたいだったから起こさないでおいてやったよ。あの時の礼をまだ言ってなかったな。ガリアド。Oh,
this is Galliardo.
助かったよ。礼には及ばん。 そもそも 9年前に俺が鎧を継承していればこんなことにはならなかった。兄貴がお前をかばってその辺の巨人に食われることもなかった。マルセルの記憶を見たのか?いいや。だが全身のユミルって女のことは少し分かった。大層の名前をつけられた哀れな女だ。ユミル?兄貴のアギトを返してくれたのもあの女の意思だろう。
ああ、そうだ。じゃあお前はあの島で何をしたんだ?誰かに助けられてばかりじゃねえかよ。ああ。
女の記憶を通してお前を見たが、あれはなんだ。随分と頼れる男を気取っていたようだったが、まるで兄貴の真似事じゃねえか。
Who is his brother?
艦砲射撃を食らった人をいじめちゃダメだよ。
その名で呼ぶな、ピグ。
大丈夫か。
人間に戻るのは2ヶ月ぶりだからね。その度に二足歩行を忘れてしまうよ。それよりライナー、ガビたちに顔を見せてあげなよ。すごく心配してたよ。
Is this chick the one who's the crawling freaking weirdo Titan? She just said, what'd she just say? Yeah, she said it's been 2 months since I've been a human. So is she stuck in that that like crawling Titan thing for like a whole 2 months, and then she just finally got out of it? This is so interesting, because we've never seen the side of, like, really, like, the Marlins, if you will, and, like, Aaron, or not Aaron, sorry, Reiner, and, like, Berthold and whatnot, and, like, where they, like, they came from, their upbringing and stuff, like, it's almost like they have, like, it's weird, because I'm, like, I'm seeing so many, like, people that are, like, you know, like, straight-up images of, like, of like the scouts basically. Like I see like a lot of like Mikasa and like Gabby, and like I see almost kind of like a bit of his name is Gillard, that's right, or Gillard, I think is how you say it. I see almost like a little bit of like Levi maybe in Gillard. And then, I don't know about, like, Reiner. I guess Reiner would be, like... Armin being the Colossal Titan now, and, like, Eren's obviously, like, resembling, like, the Beast Titan, I guess. And then, yeah. Something like that. But, yeah, it's interesting. That must be who that crawling one is, the like almost like transport person. You guys have to remind me what the Titan is called again. I'm so sorry. I got that's the one name I didn't remember for some reason.
その度に二足歩行を忘れてしまうよ。それよりライナー、ガビたちに顔を見せてあげなよ。すごく心配してたよ。
そうしよう。
はあ、疲れた。
久しぶりに会った気がするな。
戦場じゃいつも一緒だったろ。
まあしばらくは休めるだろう。
だといいね。
こっちよ。
なあ、巨人が戦争で役に立たなくなったら、俺たち戦士隊はエルディア人はどうなるんだろうな。
Love the sound effect.
ブラウンさんなら大丈夫だ。
分かってる。
俺は。
おそらく無垢の巨人の襲撃を食らって生き延びた敵兵だ。本国に戻ったら巨人兵器の非人道性を訴えるマスコットにされる。そしたらエルディア人の立場はますますひどくなる一方だ。世界の皆さん、ユミルの民は殺しましょう。
ほら、ウゴ、町の者に当たるな。
ライナー、もう歩いていいの？
ああ、みんなも無事だったか。ガビ、
うん、
ウド、
まあね、
ゾフィア、
普通です。
ファルコ、
どうも。
ねえ、私たちレベリオの本部に帰れるんだって。それまでにこの町を回ろう。
おい、
こんな機会めったにないよ。
ブラウンさんは寝てた方がいいんじゃないですか。
大丈夫だ、心配ない。
ファルコが帰って寝てな。
俺も行くよ。待て、ガビ、そっちは子供が行っちゃダメだって。マガと隊長が。
でも私、隊長が言ってるの見たよ。
心配する。
待って。
What was that? Jeez, Reiner is so much older now. He's calling them kids.
エルディアのメガミ、ガビの勇姿を。ガビは800の投資に代わり、果敢にも装甲列車に挑んだんだぞ。ちょっとコルト、お客さん。なぜそんなことしたバカだね。投資職員よ、君らには分かるか。このバカ誰が誰のために命を張ったか。俺には分かるぞ。それは君たちエルディア人部隊のために他ならない。
Okay, so, Colt's a little bit, off the chain there. It seems like he's a little bit of a loose cannon. Oh my gosh, and he's gonna be the next Beast Titan? Interesting. This is so funny. It's like, I feel like I'm, like, watching, like, almost like this, it's like, I'm almost, like, watching, like, the beginning of season one from, like, the Marley standpoint, where, like, I mean, season one of the show obviously didn't start off the war, but it was, like, there was still battle and stuff, because, like, the Titans were, like, you know, because obviously, you know, Colossal Titan broke down Juan Maria, and then Armored Titan broke down the next one, and whatnot, and then they were all coming in, and just massive chaos and shit like that. So it's, like, it's funny, though, it's, like, I'm seeing, like, so many resemblances of, like, people. They're, like, lining up with that in the scouts, you know? Like, this is just kind of mind-boggling to me. This is, like, crazy.
やつらを黙らせています。今宵だけだ。目をつぶろう。また見事に担がれたな。兄に酒を飲ませるのが悪いんです。ガビの奴もすぐ調子に乗る。しかし、
実際に鎧の継承権を獲得するのはガビになりそうだ。ええ、あなたを慕う少女がこのまま鎧を継承すれば、ガビの寿命は27歳。ああ、艦砲射撃の的にならなければですが、あなたはそれでいいんですか。今お前なんて言った。9つの巨人を継承する名誉を冒涜したのか。<笑>もしこれを報告したら、
I mean, I almost kind of want to see Falco here inherit it, because he looks more like a good follow-up. Like, he looks like a little, like a younger version of Reiner, which is so funny. And, that's interesting. I would have never made that connection, that Cole is Falco's older brother. That would be an interesting duo, because you would see a Beast Titan older brother with the younger brother being the Armored Titan. That'd be such an interesting combination. But I'm also fascinated what, like, a Gabby type of Armored Titan would look like being a female like that, you know? That'd be, like, I feel like really wild looking. So I don't know. That's interesting. Yeah, we'll see.
待ってください。発言を訂正させてください。戦士候補生ファレコグライスは己の一族を悪しい海の力解放すべく、この地を生涯マーレに捧げます。では9つの巨人を継承する名誉を何と心得る。名誉マーレ人として栄誉と誇りを授かり、祖国マーレの忠誠を存分に示す権利が得られることと存じます。鎧の巨人を継承したいのか。
鎧の巨人を継承するのは俺です。そうだ。お前がガビを救い出すんだ。この真っ暗な俺たちの未来から。Interesting.
Iron bands are used to differentiate the Eldian devils. It is mandatory for Eldians and Marley to wear their armband when they go outside. Failure to do so will result in punishment. Oh yeah, yeah, because we saw that in season 3. My brain. Jeez. Okay, that makes sense. It's interesting, though, because, like I said, I honestly, I kind of fully agree. Like, it's almost like saying, like, oh, who should get the Titan powers, like, Mikasa or Eren? And it's like, yeah, Mikasa as a Titan would be a fucking insane, but, like, Eren was, like, the right choice because of his determination to basically, well, for one, he was given to him by his dad, of course, for one thing. But also, it made the most sense for him, I think, because he had such there's such a strong meaning behind his, like, wanting to basically kill all the Titans because one of them ate his fucking mom, you know? And so, it only makes sense. And it was just, like, the pure hatred and, like, the determination to just kill off all the Titans or whatnot was so strong that it just only made sense that his Titan would be so successful like it is. So that's interesting. That's cool. Like I said, again, so many resemblances. It's wild. That is his hometown he always talked about. So Reiner's hometown was Liberio. That's how you say it. Well, you know, look at that. Reiner finally got to return to his hometown. Good for him. Still hate his guts because he's technically not a good person. But, you know, good for him. He made it home. Now hopefully Eren will shove it up his butt and kill him. No, I'm kidding. But, yeah, no, bad Reiner. Don't like him.
大きい声出すなって。ボルトが欲しそうな顔してたからボルトが欲しそうな顔してたからまったくピークちゃんの思いやりを車両中に吐き散らすなんて昨晩は黙らせるべきだった昨日はまんまと担がれたんだってなだってコルトがいいじゃない
担がれるうちが花だよ。実際大活躍だったんだもん。ピクサ。ブラウン副長。もし副長が俺と同じ考えで、エルディア人を戦争から解放したいんだとしたら、信じていいのか？
じゃあな。しばらくゆっくり休めよ。いえ。明日からまた訓練なので。あんた何張り切ってんの？点数稼ぎ。そんなんじゃねえ。二人とも。あんま無理しちゃダメだよ。
I like her voice. Her voice actor's got a great voice. I like it.
お父さん。
So, I was thinking, is that... Is that the grandparents from Dinah's side? Or is that also technically Eren's grandparents? My guess is it's probably the ones on Dinah's side. Because, we haven't really ever heard about Eren's grandparents. So that's what I'm assuming. That's my guess, at least. It's his mom! Nice.
Kosuro-san,負傷兵ですか?邪魔すんなよ、デコガキ。人的外傷を張っちまったエルディア人だ。
あ、もうしょっちゅう。長いこと前線で塹壕掘ってるとこうなっちまうらしい。弾とか爆弾が降ってくるからな。ドカーン！
おい、また転んじまったじゃねえか。
大丈夫ですか？落ち着いてください。 あなたは腕章が逆だ。大丈夫ですよ、きっと良くなりますよ。もうあなたは戦わなくていいんですから。
ドクター！狙った通り、装甲列車は脱線してひっくり返った。作戦大成功。でも敵は逃げ去る私に機関銃を撃ってきた。鉛玉を食らう寸前のところでガリアードさんがアギトの巨人で私を守ってくれたの。
So his titan's called the Jaw Titan. Okay. I guess that makes sense, kind of. Because just like the way that it's like all like the face structure and everything looks almost like a like a jaw, like a bone jaw or something. I don't know. I guess it just makes sense in my brain. I don't know. Okay, so is that the that must be the ninth? Is that the ninth then Titan that we just haven't learned about yet? Maybe it is. Interesting.
Bagabi!
お前の勇気が多くの同胞の命を救ったんだ。お前はエルディアの救世主だ。
あなたは自慢の娘よ。
ライナー、ガビは戦士になれそうなのかい？
ああ、ガビが鎧の巨人の継承権を得るのは決定的だと思う。
それはよかった。一族から二人も戦士を授かるなんて誇りに思うよ。あとはあの島に住む悪魔どもさえ消えてくれれば、エルディア人はみんな幸せになれるのにね。
でもライナ、お前でさえ島の悪魔から逃げるのがやっとだったんだろ。
ダメだよお父さん。凶悪で残虐な悪魔たちの住む島に5年も潜入してたんだよ。どんなに辛い目にあったか、機密情報じゃなくたって言えないよ。
そうだな、我が老いよ、悪かった。
Nephew.
話せることも。
Ah. So Gabby is a cousin of Reiner, because her parents are his uncle and aunt. Interesting. Very interesting. Huh.I did not see that coming at all. That just doesn't... That just... That's something I could have never guessed. What? This is so fascinating to, like, see, like, this side of Reiner. Like, there's always so much mystery behind him. But now it's like we're learning so much all of a sudden. And it's, like, actually really, really kind of cool. Not gonna lie. I mean, it's...Sucks that he's the bad guy and stuff and whatnot, and you know, obviously I'm team Aaron all the way and the rest of the crew, but yeah, it's interesting. It's finally nice to like learn finally about his family and whatnot, and the fact that we know finally his hometown and whatnot, like everything we all were questioning in the first three seasons is finally being answered. It's so nice to finally get some damn answers after all this. Like, my goodness.Took us long enough to get there, but hey, we're finally here. I like it.
ある。俺はあの島で軍隊に潜入したんだ。連中はまさしく悪魔で残虐非道な奴らだったよ。入隊式の最中、突然芋を食い出した奴がいた。教官が咎めると、悪びれる様子もなく答えた。うまそうだから盗んだと。そんな悪党だが、さすがにまずいと思ったのか、芋を半分譲ると言った。しかし、差し出した芋は半分には到底満たないものだった。奴らに譲り合う精神などないからな。本当にどうしようもない奴らだった。便所に入るなりどっちを出しに来たのか忘れるバカだったり、自分のことしか考えてねえ不真面目な奴に、人のことばっかり考えるクソ真面目な奴、突っ走るしか頭にねえ奴に、何があってもついていく奴らだったり。
I have no idea which one they're talking about.
そこに俺たちもいた。そこにいた日々はまさに地獄だった。少し話しすぎた。忘れてくれ。
いろんな奴らって何？悪い奴らでしょ。
そうだよガビ。島にいるのは 世界を地獄にした悪魔だ。いつまた強大な巨人で世界を踏みつぶし進撃してくるかわからない。それを阻止するのは私たち善良なエルディア人でなくてはならない。
I love how there's two sides of the story. It's like they're all the same freaking, like, you know, people, if you will. They're all freaking Eldians, but for some reason, the ones that escaped and went, or not really escaped, but like went to the island are suddenly devils and whatnot. And the ones that decided to stay with the Marleys are all considered, oh, good Eldians, you know, and whatnot. And the thing is, like, that's so confusing because it's like, like, there's, because there's Marleyans, and there's Eldians. So it's like, it's okay. Because it's like, there's Marleyans, then there's the good Eldians that are obeying the Marley government and whatnot, and staying in the wall like they're supposed to. And then there's the devil ones that are the ones that all are like, because they're saying, like, oh, yeah, all the Eldians that can turn into Titans and blah, blah, blah. But it's like, that means that they can probably do, they can do the same thing. So why is it, like, why are the island Eldians, the devil, for being able to turn into Titans and whatnot, why are they going to destroy the world when they have the exact same abilities to do the same thing and they're good? Like, what? Just the nonsense is very much, you know, very real, we'll say. I just, this just cracks me up. It's just, it's like, who, it's like, it's everybody pointing fingers at each other. You're to blame. No, you're the one who's the problem. You're the problem. No, you're the problem. It's like, oh, this is amazing. This is such brilliant writing. It truly confuses the audience, but if you really pay attention, you'll probably, most of you probably caught on fairly quickly, I'm sure. But for me, it's still kind of confusing, and I'm sure I'll get there. But yeah. This is just great.
私たちを置き去りにして島に逃げた奴らに制裁を与えなくてはならない。私たちを見捨てた奴らに。
The fuck was that?
どうしたガビ？元気がないな。
おばさんすごく心配してたよ。島から一人だけ帰ってきて別人みたいになったって。
12歳だった息子がおっさんになって帰ってくればさぞか心配させるだろう。
なんか嘘ついてる。
嘘？何のことだ。
私にはわからないけど、カリナおばさんにはわかるみたいだったよ。
おはようございます。
全員揃ったな。
珍しいですね、戦士長の部屋に集合なんて。マーレ軍の人は？
この部屋には
ね、
お茶ぐらいたまにはいいだろう。
はあ、
ほう。
さて、先の戦いで通常兵器が巨人兵器を上回る未来がより明確に知れ渡った。マーレが弱ればエルディア人はより生存権を脅かされる立場になる。これは民族滅亡の危機だ。唯一の解決策は早急に始祖の巨人とパラディ島の資源をマーレに収めること、うん、まずは改めてあの島の脅威を強く世界に知らしめなければならない。物語には語り手が必要だ。それをタイバー家が引き受けてくれるそうだ。
戦中の巨人を管理するタイバー家。
ウォーハマー、 The Warhammer Titan. There's another one?So, interesting. So the Tybers, is that how you say it? The Tybers, maybe? Let me see how you said it.
語り手が必要だ。それをタイバー家が引き受
けてくれる。Tyber, okay, yeah, Tyber. Yeah.
潜水の巨人を管理するタイバー
家。Yeah. Holding the Warhammer Titan. That sounds sick.That's probably one of the best names they've come up with so far. The Warhammer Titan? Are you shitting me? That sounds sick. I want to see the Warhammer Titan. Holy crap, that's awesome. I mean, maybe not so much for Aaron and the rest of the squad, but like, that sounds cool. I want to see the Warhammer Titan. Hell yeah. I feel like a like, video game like, based around like, Attack on Titan would be sick. Like, I would love to be able to like, go around like, as like Aaron, just like, flying through like, stuff like... you know, like almost like a Spider-Man type of like type of thing. But then like being able to like press X and then he like bites his finger, turns into Titan, and then you just go around and rampage. It'd be it'd be like Hulk or something like that, just going around just smashing shit and whatnot. And like, that'd be a fun ass video game. I would play that for sure. All right, sorry. I just love that name so much. That's cool.
確かにタイバー家は一度も巨人の力を敵国に向けたことがない。
Oh.
何より巨人大戦でフリッツ王を退けた一族として諸外国に顔が利く。世界は耳を傾けざるを得ないでしょう。
さすがピークちゃんだ。その通りだよ。
しかし、広い土地で優雅に暮らしてきたタイバー家が今さら出てきて英雄を気取るなんて虫が良すぎませんか。
気持ちはわかるが、タイバー家も祖国マーレを憂いているんだ、うん、
しかし、俺たちは
これで祖国マーレが救われるならありがたいことです。俺たち戦士隊もタイバー家と協力して英雄国マーレ復活の礎となりましょう、
うん、そうだ。近くこのレベリオで祭事が行われる。
祭事？
諸外国の要人や記者を招いてタイバー家は宣言を行う。1年以内にパラディ島を制圧すると。エルディア人とマーレの運命はこの作戦にかかっている。もう失敗は許されない。祖国マーレの未来のために今一度皆の心を一つにしよう。
ガリアードは多少不満があるようだが、まあ任務となれば徹底するやつだ。
密室でこの内容なら問題ないだろう。
ジークの一言がなければな。
うん？
この部屋にはいない。
なんですか？
俺はまた行くのか、あの島へ。
No way. Reiner is going to return to the island. I mean, that makes sense. I mean, let's be honest. There's no doubt in my mind that when we see that he's actually totally fine, that we weren't going to see probably yet another showdown between him and Eren. Although, honestly, I would love to see... I want to see, like, a showdown between, like, Eren, as obviously his attack titan, and then, Armin, my gosh, Armin as the colossal titan, and just like have those, it would be like Eren versus armor titan, and then colossal titan versus beast titan. Although I don't know if that would work very well, because I mean we don't even know how well that Armin can control the colossal titan yet, and so I don't know if that would go well. But it would be so cool. It would just be the most awesome showdown ever. It'd be so freaking cool. anyways. But, yeah, I think what I really like about this so far is we're finally getting to see, like, the side of the Marleyans and kind of almost hearing their side of the story. So it's almost like they kind of give... It's like they kind of are giving us the opportunity now to switch sides almost if we want to. Like, oh, are you in favor of the island Eldians, or do you want the, you know, Marley Eldians that obey the Marley government now and blah, 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 you know? But, like, you know... I mean, as a viewer from me myself, I don't think I could ever turn on the Paradise Island Eldians, because that's where you have the crew that we've seen the last whole entire three seasons, you know. But now it's like we're seeing this new crew from the Marleyans, where you see, like, you know, where you see, like, oh, like, on one side you have Eren, Mikasa, Connie, Jean, Levi, all those guys, and then on the other side you got, you know, Reiner, what's the jaw titan? I can't remember his name for some reason. Gilliard or whatever his name is. Then you got the jaw titan, then you got the Reiner's titan, and then you got obviously Gabby and Falco and his brother. What's his name? I'm doing pretty good with the names, actually. I'm surprised myself. What's his name? Not Duke. I don't think. I can't remember Falco's brother's name right now. But yeah, and so it's like I said, you're almost seeing like two different sides now. So it's like, I feel like the ultimate showdown could almost be like, almost like the Beast Titan squad versus like the Levi squad. Although I don't know how that would go, because 90% of the Beast Titan squad is all Titans or potential Titans in the future. Whereas, you know, Eren's side, you have two Titans. So it's kind of is outnumbered in certain ways. But, yeah, it's just so funny to me because it's like, just because they are on, just because they decide to go and like separate themselves on an island and stay true to their actual true ancestors, they're known as the Devil Ones and stuff, which is like the complete opposite because that's not what Ymir is at all. Like, Ymir is like a founding goddess, basically. Well, I mean, I guess she technically sold her, like, something, whatever it was, to the devil to be able to get Titan powers. But whatever, it does. Whatever. I digress. It's so funny to see. Like, it's like Eldians versus Eldians, but also not really in the same kind of way, you know? It's like, it's so confusing. If you try to explain this to somebody, like, just like to try to get them into this anime, not only would you be giving a lot of spoilers, but like, you would just like confuse the absolute living hell out of people. It would be so funny to see their brains like just like what. I mean, I'm honestly not perfect. I still don't have everything down, of course, but you know what I mean. So yeah, but anyways, guys, yeah, so that was episode number 2 of season 4, and I'm definitely looking forward to more episodes, of course. But for right now, I gotta go eat some dinner, so I'm gonna record some more episodes probably tomorrow. This is not obviously gonna make any sense to you because you're gonna be watching this next week, but you know what I mean. Or, well, today will be Monday for you guys, so I'm recording this last Thursday is when I'm recording this, so yeah. But anyways, I digress. Anyways, guys, I'm sorry. What I was trying to get to a point is I'm looking forward to the rest of the season. It's gonna be very, very chaotic, I can tell, and I love the chaos, so let's bring it on. Anyways, guys, thank you always for watching this episode. I will see you in the next one. Alrighty, guys, bye.